So, I was gonna make a video trying to be all deep and serious and make a point about some things, but sometimes boys just gotta blow off steam.
You know who's the real ringrider? Seth, the Fire Perry.
So I've been wanting to talk about something for a while now. I just haven't really known how to approach it for a couple of. First of all, because I'm pretty much stuck here where a lot of the people are just really narrow-minded and bigoted. And I don't really want some hate-filled redneck white supremacist or something showing up with a shotgun at my front door, you know? And secondly, because I really don't want to become the public face for a community that I don't exactly feel that I'm a part of. I mean, technically, I would be a part of that community. I just don't really feel that I'm accepted because, for the most part, from what I can see and as far as I can tell about it online, it appears to be mostly young people from more so wealthy families who are able to afford this sort of thing. And I'm just so much older than they are, and I don't have gobs and gobs of money. So it's just the age-old misunderstanding between the haves, not understanding what it's like for the have-nots of this world. So yeah, but I did make a video about a month or so ago trying to tiptoe around this issue and sort of ease people into the way that I prefer to be addressed. It's the one where I said, "Don't call me a bitch and don't call me a dyke. If you have to be that vulgar, at least get it correct and call me a faggot if you must." Because a dyke is a slur for a lesbian who is a woman who is attracted to other women, and neither is the case for me. Not that it's anyone's business, but I am not attracted to women, never have been, never will be. And furthermore, I'm not a woman. And you may be thinking, you know, what the fuck, wondering why I'm trying to up and flip the script. You know, being that it's so late in life and after I've done things like the whole Big Issues series, among other things in the past. But that's when I thought I had this label on my forehead. You know, that invisible tattoo we receive when we're born that either says male or female and tells us that we have no other choice but to declare ourselves according to that label that they give us. And this is why I'm having trouble recording my video. But yeah, especially living here in West Virginia, and I do imagine there are other places like this, other small towns, where men are sperm donors and women raise babies and are perpetually barefoot and pregnant all their lives. And in places like this, you know, people literally do not see beyond their front porch at all. That this is life, this is who you are, this is what you're supposed to do. You hang your head and you keep your place. You do as you're expected to. And most people who aren't complete psychopaths or sociopaths have an ingrained, natural, born instinct to people please and seek approval from others. And that is just a product of our society. Because our society seems to be free on the surface, but everything is really socially controlled and constructed to keep people in their place. And we get that from absolutely everything and everyone around us. And it's human nature to seek positive response and praise from others. Even for, you know, people who do bad things, make fun of others, sleep around, or do drugs, or whatever. If someone receives what appears to be positive response for their actions, they will continue in those actions. And that's especially true for those that feel that they continually need to put others down in order to make themselves feel validated and special. Fear of rejection drives them to seek more false praise through diminishing others. But anyway, I've had over a year to think about things, to process everything, to research, to soul search, and to reevaluate everything I've ever thought. And although I'm still very much a work in progress, I am constantly moving forward through this life. But here's a quick rundown of some of the things that have brought me to this conclusion. As a little kid, I played with G.I. Joes, Transformers, and Matchbox cars. I would take my aunt's makeup and paint my face in green and brown and black to run around playing army men. I was allowed to wear boys' clothes at home, even though I was forced to wear god-awful, hideous, pink and purple, frilly things to school, to church, and in public. Since the age of 15, all of my clothes have been exclusively men's. Since around the age of 22 or 23, I've been wearing boxer briefs. The only women's thing I own are sports bras out of pure necessity. I use Axe products and have chosen Bulgari Man as like my signature cologne, if you will. So what's the difference between being a tomboy and myself? I believe that tomboys grow out of it. By their late teenage years, they accept things like having long hair and dressing feminine in order to attract boyfriends and a husband, but not me. And also, generally, tomboys don't feel all too ashamed or humiliated by dressing and appearing feminine as I have felt. So what has changed with me? Nothing other than my perspective, my understanding of myself, and understanding that I do have a choice and that I can be the master of my own destiny. And also the acceptance of myself and acceptance of the responsibility that I have to myself to somehow emerge from this godforsaken hellhole as a new man. To come out on the other side as my true self. The real me that has been denied, repressed, stomped on, shit on, beat down, and kept down for far too long. And who knows what may be, but I am, as always, trying to rise above the bullshit. And if bullshit were measured in pennies, then I'd be a billionaire, because all I've ever faced is bullshit and opposition in my life. So it is going to be a very long and very hard road out of hell. Depression is a bitch, and so is the constant level of negativity and hatred around me. Rising above that much negativity will definitely be hard. And yes, the big, dark cloud of negativity and hatred that people have always brought to me has always been my downfall in the past. But like they say, Rome wasn't built in a day. And like the Walgreens commercials, we don't live in perfect. Things don't fall from the sky. Problems don't get fixed by the end of the episode. You know what I'm saying? Things take time. But the one change I would like to see effective immediately is to not be called a bitch or a dyke. If you must be insulting or bigoted, at least call me a bastard or a faggot instead. And for those who have the ability to be more polite, I would like to be called Seth. As if you haven't yet seen it on my channel, on my Facebook, or on my Twitter. It's been there for a little while now. And I would like to not be called a she or a her, because that's not who I am. That's a different person. I do kind of just feel like I've been given someone else's identity and have been forced to live in someone else's shoes, and it just all seems so foreign to me now with this new perspective. It's kind of funny how in the past I was considered slightly dissociative because I felt kind of like my life was not my own. Yeah, who knew gender would be the culprit? But yeah, the person inside me, the soul, or the mind, whatever you want to call it, whatever it may be, the person inside is not the person whose birth certificate, driver's license, and other forms of ID I've been given in this life. The real me, buried inside under years and years of everyone else's shit, and some of my own shit too, is a guy named Seth. And I'm going to bring back the Fat to Fighter series, I think. Or at least I do have one new episode in the work. And that is set for approximately a month and a half from now, until I launch the new episode. I have a goal set in mind that I hope to reach by a certain date, because it will be a real huge kick in the face to all the haters that said I couldn't. And I'm really super psyched and looking forward to that. So yeah, you heard it here first. Peace out, and whoop whoop.